The long pause before the next dance begins, March 26, 2017. By Lisa Gallas. Webpage, www.mysoulcenter.com. The Dance of Life. On the pre-dawn oceanside communion I had with God, I sat there thinking about the humbling GoFundMe project that was started and the funds that were so lovingly given to me through so many people. My desire and query to Source was, what can I do for them, in return? Not only the people who opened their hearts and wallets, but those who held the love light firm to make sure I get my new teeth. My heart so full of gratitude, and I even wondered, maybe give the money back since I will have the money from the house sale soon. God said, let's done one better than that. Suddenly, about 15 feet above the mist on the ocean, these things started to form. They reminded me of a network of arteries that came out of this center mass of energy. All of it was the color of the mist over the ocean, but solid, not misty. I think the closest idea of what it looked like was an octopus, minus the suction cups and many more than 8 arteries. They all stretched down to blend into the fog, into Source. He said, he can share back in ways I could never even think of, since he knows everyone intimately. Which reminds me of something else that was stated during my pre-dawn communions. I was pondering this nation of light gig, and suddenly I heard a little snippet from the Pledge of Allegiance. Not that I participate in any of that, but I think our forefathers, in their state of evolved chaos, understood something bigger, but because they were still in separation. The nation of light, one nation through God, not under, we are not subservient to Source in any way. If we look at this formation of you, all connected at a Source head, as the Godhead, with purpose, in this case, that would be getting teeth for me, spread out in all directions, different sizes, and all equal, blending into the fog of the ocean, into the energy that is Source everywhere. You, each and every one of you, truly are the Godhead, all one, individually. What any of us put out, without agenda or expectation, must flow back into the realm of its original Source. All energies, when pure, must remain whole at all times. Oftentimes, it may flow into a personal or collective storehouse, for later use. Expectation, no matter how large or small, clogs the artery in which it was released from. The core of any cardiovascular dysfunction. To change the subject, halfway through yesterday, I reread my blog. Hey, just because I type it all out, doesn't mean it came from me and I need to go back and absorb again. I realized I not only typed out command, the words on demand never even entered my mind. The flyer said your wishes on demand, but that was not even part of my memory as I typed. Of course, when I realized this, I had to Google the difference between demand and command, just to be clear inside myself. I about shit, commanding comes with authority. Demand, on the other hand, is a firm request. Unlike in the case of a command, a demand does not come from a position of power. Demand usually involves a struggle. I have no problem with being demanding, or the twists and turns that come from it, the struggle to arrive at my demands, but commanding, view baby, you can feel how intensely different that is. The energy is, just, instant, powerful. But even, so much more than that. For me personally, a bit intimidating, but in a good way. Something even bigger grew as I was pondering this last evening. I could see the first group of us, set up at one of the amazing Greek resorts sitting almost in the ocean, on the last 3 days, commanding, but not so much barking out orders, but something, so much more, and filling the ocean with that. Every ocean interconnects with every ocean on this planet, which branches outwards to become rivers and streams. Accessible to all, through the life force of H20. which made me fully realize you don't have to be present at the workshops to participate. You just have to be in your presence and drink a glass of water, sort of. What we do for one, or 12, we do for the all. Subject change one more time. We are all in the thick of it right now. Have been since mid-March. The energy surges are constant. The sun doing its part on a daily basis. The field, completely unviewable as we all go through inner and outer changes, energetically speaking, for many, like myself, literally speaking too. From space weather. Come today. Potent corneal hole faces Earth. A canyon-shaped hole in the sun's atmosphere is facing Earth, and it is spewing a stream of fast-moving solar wind toward our planet. NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory photographed the giant fissure on March 25. This is a corneal hole, CH, a vast region where the sun's magnetic field opens up and allows solar wind to escape. A gaseous stream flowing from this corneal hole is expected to reach our planet on during the late hours of March 27 and could spark moderately strong G2 class geomagnetic storms around the poles on March 28 or 29. We've seen this corneal hole before. In early March, it lashed Earth's magnetic field with a fast-moving stream that sparked several consecutive days of intenser auras around the poles. The corneal hole is potent because it is spewing solar wind threaded with negative polarity magnetic fields. Such fields do a good job connecting to Earth's magnetosphere and energizing geomagnetic storms. If we look at this energy as well as what is coming up from the core of Gaia, we can see how the only visual I received coming back from Marco Island affects us all, zero field. Although I cannot see the field, information is still being released through our conversations, at least, about what is happening. These energies are turning on brand new light switches and turning off old ones, all within the individual human's allowance. Free will and all that. This will be the way of it through the rest of this month. However, that said, we are in a constant choice point of change every moment of every day through this system. What we are willing to let go of, what we are willing to feel or not feel. To stay centered in the unknowable excitement is essential, unless, of course, you are wanting to recreate more of the same for yourself, a very valid choice. But every moment, when you switch how you are feeling inside, the layout of the landscape we are calling your next personal phase, changes to reflect that new energy within you. With that understood, Spirit doesn't even know what we will create as we emerge out of this energy infusion. We can easily use my crazy life as a prime example. Something emerges out of the abyss of potential, you steer your excited ship towards that and wham, something else shows up in place of it. But let's be clear here on the word excited. We are not talking over joy happy, but more like the excited state of molecules. Excited state. In quantum mechanics, an excited state of a system, such as an atom, molecule or nucleus, is any quantum state of the system that has a higher energy than the ground state, that is, more energy than the absolute minimum. Excitation is an elevation in energy level above an arbitrary baseline energy state. Our path is not a solo path. So when someone else's excited ship is in harmony with yours in the bigger picture, change happens and happens again, and then again. When you are willing to move towards any of it, dropping one for the other, that is flow. If we can look at these sudden inspirations like mile markers upon our path, don't get hung up on anyone until you can feel life growing through it within yourself. Some things will show up just to get you motivated in a new direction. Sometimes, one of those things is an energetic storage point to pull from. For me personally, that is becoming the zone of silence in Mexico. Every single time I point my life beam towards that place, everything in my world changes. This is the third time in a year one attempted to point my body to that place and something new comes from it, but not Mexico itself. Lol, it does crack me up. I have decided my storehouse of energy is located in the zone of silence, silently taking me to my next grand adventure of myself. Life is an ever-moving square dance, changing, rearranging and occasionally, stillness as the next song gets ready to play. Are you ready? More importantly, are you willing? Big, big hugs, filled with wonder and new energy to and through all. Lisa Gallus. www.mysoulcenter.com. For our viewing pleasure as I dance my way to Texas in a little over a week.